Today we are going to talk about hill lies. There's four kind of hill lies. There is the uphill lie, there's the downhill lie, there's the side hill lie with the ball above your feet, and there is the side hill lie with the ball below your feet. Let's start with the easiest one in my opinion, and that is uphill lie. Uphill lie is great because you get to use the loft or what the angle of the hill, and that's going to help launch your ball. This will help launch your ball in the air. So because this hill is going to help launch the ball in the air, you need to actually take more club. So for instance, if you hit an 8-iron 120 yards on this shot, you're going to want to hit a 7-iron because the hill is going to make it go higher and not travel as far. So take at least one more club. Now, my coach, Paul Horton, PGA of Canada instructor, has said, watch out on the uphill lie because uphill lies will cause the ball to draw or to hook a little bit. So again, you want to adjust for that in your alignment. Now, ball position. Ball position for the uphill lie is you want to play the ball slightly forward in your stance. Now, if you've watched any of my videos, and you would know that my ball position, we typically play the ball position for all clubs except driver with feet together, move the lead foot the width of a club head, back foot to comfort. That's the normal position. On uphill lie, my coach Paul Horton recommends a slightly forward ball position. So put that ball slightly forward in your stance, closer to that lead foot. Now, the other key that you want to focus on is balance and swing within yourself. Anytime you're on a hill lie, it's going to throw you off balance. So you don't want to be swinging out of your shorts. Do your normal swing here and know it's going to be hard to finish your golf swing. All right? So again, keep that balance and swing within yourself. So that uphill lie, take more club. Ball position is going to be slightly ahead of normal. Take that little bit more club. Know that the uphill lie is going to draw or pull or hook a little bit. So you want to adjust for that in your alignment, and you're going to make that swing. Awesome. Oh, great shot. So that's the uphill lie. Let's talk about downhill lie. Now, downhill lie works exactly the opposite. The downhill lie, the slope of the hill, is going to make this ball come out fast and also low. So again, if you hit your 8-iron 120 yards, you actually want to take a 9-iron because this ball will travel farther because it's a lower trajectory coming off this downslope. So again, take one less club. What is the ball position for downhill lie? So the ball position for downhill lie is actually going to be back in your stance, according to my coach, Paul Horton. So again, you would take your normal stance of feet together, move the lead foot, the width of a club head, and you want to make sure that ball is back in your stance so that you're contacting that ball first as you come through impact. Really important. Again, balance is really important here. Balance and swing within yourself. Know that you might not get to finish that swing, so just do your best job of staying balanced. So again, you've taken a little less club because it's going to travel and roll more. The ball's back in your stance. Swing within yourself and stay balanced. Awesome. Awesome. So again, really important keys. All right, let's talk about sidehill lies. Sidehill lies. These are even a little trickier because I find you really lose your balance on the sidehill lies. So let's start with sidehill lie. We're going to go below the feet. So what does sidehill lie below the feet look like? Sidehill lie below the feet, what's going to happen is when you make your swing, it's really easy for you to lose your balance. So if you can see here, I'm going to make a swing and it's really easy for me to lose my balance. So here's an extra tip if you're struggling with balance on any of your hill lies. I want you to pretend you're standing on a Bosu ball. Pretend you have bare feet on. I want you to take your toes and grip them into that Bosu ball. Feel like you're gripping in, and you'll do that in your golf shoes and you're going to feel extra stability. So right before you take your backswing, feel like you're gripping your toes onto a Bosu ball, all right? That will help with your balance. Ball position on a side hill lie, either above or below your feet, is exactly the same. Still, again, it's going to be feet together. Move the lead foot the width of a club head, back foot to comfort, all right? So on this one, again, you want to squeeze your feet like the Bosu ball. What you're going to find on your side hill lies, you're going to lose your balance even more. So again, that's really key to do that Bosu ball. Now, if you want to know which way your ball is going to travel, a great little trick on side hill lies, when you would swing, you see how I'm falling forward. Well, that's the way your ball is going to want to travel too. So when you have a side hill lie with the ball below your feet, it's going to want to slice or fade. So again, you're going to want to adjust your alignment before you hit. You don't want to hit straight at the flag because you know that ball is probably going to fade or slice. So you're going to want to adjust a little bit. All right. All right. Let's do that side hill lie. So again, it's feet together, move the lead foot, the width of a club head. So normal ball position. We're going to squeeze the feet in like a Bosu ball. All right. And know that this is going to fade or slice a little bit. All right. Oh, perfect. All right, last one. Our last hill lie is going to be the side hill lie with the ball above our feet. Now, how do we do this one? Again, ball position is the same as normal. Ball position is going to be right feet together, move the lead foot the width of a club head, back foot to comfort. Now, which way, if I was to do a practice swing, you're gonna see here, if I do a practice swing, that I have the tendency to fall backwards. So that's the way that my ball is gonna travel. My ball is gonna tend to travel the way that you would fall if you didn't have your balance. So please remember to adjust your alignment accordingly. Now again, when you're on these hill lies, it's really important that you brush the grass. Now, with the uphill lie, my club or my ball is a little closer to me, so I'll probably want to choke down my grip a little bit. A practice swing is really important on hill lies, so I'll choke up a little bit because the ball is closer to me, and as long as I can brush my grass, I'm good. On a downhill lie, this one's super tricky because the ball is farther away from me, so it's really important I try to keep my chest level to brush that grass. If you can brush your grass, you know you're great. Okay, sidehill lie, ball above the feet, normal ball position, feet together, move the lead foot, the width of a club head, back foot to comfort. I'm gonna squeeze my toes like a Bosu ball. Now I know that I was gonna be falling towards the hole. So if you know you're gonna be falling towards the hole with the ball above your feet, then you know that this ball is going to tend to hook or pull or draw. So adjust your alignment accordingly. All right, let's do normal ball position. I've got to brush that grass, maybe choke up a little bit, and let's make this good swing. Swing within ourselves and stay in balance. There we go. Again, a little thicker, but that's right on target where I wanted to go. So those are the keys to hitting the great hill lies. I hope these help you this season to master the hills.